Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Chum here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys some very usable and very powerful combos that you can be using when playing Lucario in Pokémon Tournament. Now, the reason I use the term usable is because these aren't the kind of combos that you hit the opponent 50 times and continue to juggle them, but instead just very powerful combos that anyone can pull off very easily, even if you have some input delay from playing online. I've also used the term unbreakable in the video title, and that's because these combos are the types of combos that once you land the first hit, there's nothing your opponent can do to break out of it. And just to prove my point, I'll show you. I've set the CPU to automatically block after getting hit, so if the CPU has time to block before I land my next attack, it's obviously not going to work out. Now, the first combo I want to show you is based off the neutral X attack that you have when you use Lucario Strong. So that's this attack right here. Many of you guys already know that there is a combo based off this in the Combo Dojo, and I'll show you that really quickly. Now, while that combo does a good amount of damage, it's pretty difficult to pull off in online because there is quite a bit of input delay when playing it with other people around the world. Now, I've come up with my own variant of this combo, which is a lot easier to pull off when playing with even the tiniest bit of input delay. How this will work is X, X, forward X, and X. So you just basically spam one button with the direction in the middle, and I'll show you that right now. Now, this one doesn't do a lot of damage, however, I do have a couple of other variants that do a little bit more. The second variant is going to be X, X, up Y, up A. Now, it does a little bit more damage, and it also, in my opinion, looks a little bit cooler. However, there is one more that I have to show you that deals the most damage out of the three. Now, this one is just very simple, X, X, up and A. Now, one thing I need to mention about these two combos is the first one I showed you, even though it's the weakest, it is in my opinion the most reliable, and I'll show you why. If you have a fair bit of spacing between your opponent and yourself, even though your X attacks may hit, there is a chance that your other attacks can miss and make you drop the combo. Instead, with the same spacing, the forward X and X variant can hit every single time. So if you do think there's a little bit too much space between yourself and your opponent, you can go for the weak attack. However, if you think you're very, very close, you can go for all the damage. Now, one thing you may have noticed while watching me perform this combo is that the initiating hit, which is the basic X, takes a long time to come out after you press the button, which means it's hard to attack in the tiny windows of opportunity that you may have during a fight. Instead, another way you can initiate this attack is by leading with a mid-air Y, and I'll show you that now. As you can see right there, it does a little bit more damage, and of course if you get off the wall, you do a lot more damage. And it's definitely a lot easier to pull off. In general, Lucario's aerial attacks are really good at initiating combos, and I'll show you some combos you can initiate off the mid-air X. The first one is going to be standard Y, so you just keep spamming Y until your opponent gets hit. And one cool fact is if they put their guard down or they don't put it up once they get off the ground, you can hit it with an Aura Sphere to get the phase shift. Another follow-up for a mid-air X is down Y, Y, and A, and I'll show you that now. You can see it does a lot less damage. However, if you do want to switch it up and make yourself look a little bit cooler as you do combos, that's definitely one way to do it. Now let's move on to hitting a full counter. So let's say you fully charge your counter and you hit them. One way to follow it up is with your standard Y combo. And as you can see, Lucario has a bit of like distance between where his attack hits and where his fist ends. So make sure to keep that in mind. Now let's say you're a little bit further away. If there's even the tiniest bit of space between yourself and your opponent, when the counter finishes, they're going to be too far away for the standard Y combo. Instead, what you can do is use forward Y. The forward Y will close the gap between yourself and your opponent, allowing you to land two quick hits. And let's say your opponent is very, very far away, almost out of the range of the attack, you can follow up with a Bone Rush. Now moving on to another great initiator, I'm going to show you some combos that follow up from Lucario's up X. Lucario's high stand strong attack is great at getting in close when you have a tiny bit of distance, as well as great for avoiding a lot of low stance attacks. Now one potential follow up to this attack is an up A, which is your extreme speed. While this doesn't do a lot of damage, an Aura Sphere follow-up will get you the phase shift. Again, another follow-up to this initiator is down Y, Y, and A. However, it's important to note that an aura sphere after the attack will not guarantee a phase shift. Now moving on, I want to show you guys some wall combos. One thing that's important to note is if you're using the standard X combo, if you hit the X attack twice, you're going to end up dropping your combo. And that's because Blaziken hitting the wall twice causes him to fall down. Instead, what you want to do is you want to hit use X once and then follow it up. And as you guys saw there, using 1X and then an extreme speed doesn't actually get you the phase shift. Instead, what you should do is use single X, up Y, and then up A. Because you've got them against the wall, there's a very low chance of them getting too far away for you to land the forward Y and the up A, and this attack does some insane damage. Everything else up against the wall is going to be just fine, so there's no need to worry about that. Now I believe it's time to move on to some Mega Evolution combos. Now the first set of combos I want to show you is the same as the ones at the very beginning, however due to Lucario's differences in his forms, the moves come out a little bit differently. Now it's very important to note that the once reliable combo is now a lot less viable because it does a lot less damage than the other two, and I'll show you why. As you can see, Lucario's extreme speed has another follow-up hit, which has a gigantic range and does a good amount of damage. And of course, the most powerful variant, without the up Y, deals 241 damage. Of course, just like before, this can be easily initiated with an aerial Y. Now moving on to the mid-air X combos, a standard Y is all you're ever going to need. So just keep spamming Y and you'll see Force Palm has an additional hit, which will cause the phase shift, so no aura spheres needed. Then moving on to your full counter, once again, just keep spamming Y after the hit, and it's all you're going to need. And of course, like previously, if they're a bit too far away, you can follow up with a Bone Rush. And for our final tiny combo I want to show you guys, the Up X Initiator, which this time will now cause a phase shift with the extreme speed follow-up. Alright guys, that brings us to the end of our Lucario tutorial. If you guys learned something or if you guys enjoyed, be sure to drop a like. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, be sure to subscribe. Because as I go through the game, I'm going to try and learn every single character, and I'm going to try and share all the secrets I find with you guys. Also, I just want to let you know that I've left a pastebin link in the description below to a document containing all the combos I listed in this video, so you can check back to that for a quick reference if you ever need one. Now you're probably wondering what you're going to watch next, and I have two suggestions for you. On the right hand side, I have some more Pokémon Tournament from this series in which I do play every single character and I try and figure out exactly how to play them and see how well I can do online. And then on the left, I have a brand new series on the channel, which is Ratchet & Clank, the reboot that just came out on PS4. It's a great game. If you go check that out, I'm sure you won't be disappointed. Either way, once again, I hope you guys enjoyed, and until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day.